we are going to start with Geotechnical Engineering Unit Number 6, File Foundation. So from today we are going to see what do you mean by pile foundation first. The classification of piles, constructional features of cast in situ and pre-cast concrete piles, pile driven methods, effect of pile driven on ground, load transfer mechanism of axially loaded piles, pile capacity by static formula and dynamic formula, pile load test and interpretation of data, group action in piles, spacing of piles in groups, group efficiency, overlapping of stresses, settlement of pile group by simple approach, negative screen friction and its effect on pile capacity, general features of underhanging piles. This is what we are going to study in this pile foundation. Now, what are different types of foundations? So first is your shallow foundation, we have studied in unit number 5. Then second is your deep foundation, in which we cover pile foundation and cofferdam foundation. So what do you mean by pile? So what is pile? A pile is a slender structural member made of concrete, steel, wood or composite material. A pile is either driven into the soil or formed inside by excavating a hole and filling it with concrete. So firstly, it is made up of a slender member, a smooth vertical member, just like a column, which can be made up of concrete, which can be made up of steel, wood and composite material. Composite means made up of two materials, concrete, steel, steel, wood or wood, concrete, whatever. Then you can make a pile first and you can just put it inside the soft soil, or you can just excavate a hole as per your pile dimensions, then you can fill it with concrete and steel case. Next, what is pile foundation? Pile foundation is that type of deep foundation in which the loads are taken to a low level by means of vertical members, which may be timber, concrete and steel. Uses of pile. The load of the superstructure is heavy and its distribution is uneven. The topsoil has poor bearing capacity. The subsoil water is high so that pumping of water from the open trenches for the shallow foundation is difficult and uneconomical. Large fluctuation in subsoil water level. The structure is situated on the seashore or river bed where there is a danger of soaring action of water. Canal or deep drainage line exists near the foundation for foundation of transmission towers of offshore platforms which are subjected to uplift forces. So these are the forces or uses of pile. So first condition is, if there is the superstructure which is very heavy load and you have to distribute the load and which is uneven, then you can go for pile foundation. Next is, if your bearing capacity of the soil is poor, especially black cotton soil which is having very low bearing capacity, then you can use pile foundation. Then if you are having the open trenches where the shallow foundation is very very difficult, then you have to use the pile foundation since it is a slender member. Then if your water table is fluctuating, it is coming up, it is coming down, then you have to give the pile foundation. Then where there is a river bed and you are having the soaring action of water and very scary soil, then you use piles there. Then canal and deep drainage means you are having a long kilometers of canal to produce the water from one place to another, and you are having a deep down drainage for it. Then you need pile foundation. And transmission line towers means the electrical supply of whatever you are giving by the towers. Those are known as your transmission line towers designed by civil engineers. And here, if the soil is very soft soil, then you have to provide piles. Offshore platforms for digging the crude oil from the seabed, you need piles there. You cannot provide shallow foundations. In offshore platforms, piles are generally moreover 90 to 100 meter deep in the soil of sea. So there you need only pile foundation, you cannot provide any other foundation there. So these all are the uses of piles. So first figure, if you can see, this is soaring. Second, these are the offshore platforms for digging up of the oil, and here deep into the soil we have pile foundation. These are the transmission line towers vertically erected. So if it is provided in soft soil, you need pile foundation. Again, uses of pile: nature and type structure, location, material, equipment and fund availability, type of soil and its property, ground, water table, durability of pile, length and number of pile, case study of adjacent building, facility for pile driving, erosion of soil near structure. What are the classification of soil? So how can soil can be classified? There are three different methods based on function, based on material and based on installation. So based on material, what are the different types of piles? So these are your end bearing piles, friction pile, compaction pile, tension pile, anchor pile, feeder pile, batter pile and sheet pile. So let us study what is end bearing pile. Penetrate through the soft soil, bottom or tips rest on hard strata, work as column. For the pile, QU equals to QP, where QU is ultimate load and QP is the pile load. So this is your pile here, and this is having a load from the superstructure Q. This is the soft soil, so it is resting on the hard soil here. That's why it is known as a end bearing pile. Friction pile: loose soil extend to greater depth. Pile driven at depth with friction resistance develop equal to load. In that case, QU equals to QS. QS is the skin friction. Total friction resistance can be increased, increasing length and diameter, making pile surface rough, placing close or grouping of pile. So this is your pile, and there is no hard strata here. So when you insert the pile having a load Q on the top with respect to your ground level, so it will exert a friction in the opposite direction of the laying of the pile. So this is known as your frictional force, and this type of piles are known as your friction piles. Next is your compaction pile. Pile do not carry any load for increase the bearing capacity of the soil. So this pile is not for the carrying of loading of the soil, but you have to insert the pile. Compaction piles means you have to drive the pile down by the mechanical force, and these are only support to increase the bearing capacity of the soil. At the intervals, you have to provide this compaction piles. Tension pile: when the structure subjected to uplift due to the hydrostatic power pressure or overturning moment, also known as uplift pile. This is the multi-story building. If you can see the figure number one, what happens? In this figure number one, this is the multi-story building. So in this multi-story building, if the soil here on the ground level is very, very soft soil, then you have to apply the pile. Next, if you are having this transmission line tower, so it is a vertical member, so you have to apply, you have to provide a pile, and these piles are under-rim piles. This is a bulb provided here, which are known as your under-rimmer. And this is your water storage or water tank. So for this, you have to apply the anchor piles, so that can resist your uplift pressure of the water. These are the anchor piles. Anchor piles are to support the better piles or other piles which are going to support the foundation of any structure. So here anchor piles are provided anchorage against horizontal pull from sheet roof pulling or any other pulling. So these are all horizontal, ye jo horizontal beam hai, isko support karna hai, because this is a slender member, so this has to be tied with a horizontal bar. And when this horizontal bar is tied here, this is the anchor and better pile which are supporting your horizontal member. Feeder pile. These are used to protect waterfront structures against impact from ships or other floating objects. So these are the fender piles which are provided on offshore structures for coming in and out of the ships. There is impact loading. So to sustain that impact loading, these piles are provided. Batter piles, they are used to resist large horizontal forces or inclined forces. So if you can see here, these are the batter piles, and this is the structure horizontal member here. So for these horizontal members, these piles are provided, so that if there is any impact force coming on the piles, it can resist by the batter pile. Sheet piles, they are used as bulkheads or as impervious cutoff to reduce seepage and uplift under hydraulic structures. Sheet pile is classified as concrete sheet piles, steel sheet piles, and timber sheet piles. So if you can see, these are the steel piles, steel sheet pile used on the waterfronts to control. These are used to control the offshore water currents. Classification based on pile material. So first is your concrete pile, steel pile, timber pile, composite pile, and sand pile. So what is concrete pile? This is made of three types. One is your precast, second is cast in situ, and pre-stress. So these are your concrete piles. So concrete precast concrete pile, it is those which are manufactured in factory or at place away from the construction site and driven into the ground at the place required. So it is just like a compaction pile. You are making that in the factory and taking to the site, and just with the use of the hammers, you are driving inside the ground. It requires heavy pile driving machinery. It may be square, octagonal, or circular in cross section. The size of the pile varies 30 cm to 50 cm cross section and up to 20 meter or more length. Grade of concrete should be M20. Concrete piles are of three types: precast, cast in situ, and pre-stress. So cast in situ, a bore is dug into the ground by inserting a casing. A bore is filled with cement concrete after placing reinforcement. The casing be kept in position or it may be withdrawn. The piles with casing are known as cased cast in situ concrete pile. The piles without casing are known as uncased cast in situ concrete pile. Cased piles are Raymond piles, Mac Arthur piles, BSP base driven piles, swage piles, button bottom piles. So this is the case. This is inserted, then the cement concrete is placed inside, and these are known as your cased or in uncased cast in situ soil piles. Raymond piles, it is used preliminary as friction piles. It is provided with uniform taper of 1 meter, 1 in 30 short pile. You can see that this is having a taper 1 in 30 short, okay, shorter piles. The length of the piles vary from 6 to 12 meter. Diameter is 40 centimeter to 60. Bottom diameter 20 to 30. So this is your top diameter, which is 40 to 60, and this is your bottom diameter, which vary from 20 to 30 centimeter. Collapsible mandrel is driven into the soil ground. When the pile is driven to the desired depth, mandrel is collapsed and withdrawn. So this is your mandrel, and this is removed when you insert the pile into the ground. The shell is gradually filled with concrete up to the top. MacArthur pile. MacArthur pile is of uniform diameter using corrugated steel shell, which remain in the place as Raymond piles. A heavy steel casing with a core is driven into the ground. When the desired depth is reached, the core is withdrawn and a corrugated steel shell is placed in the casing. Concrete is placed in the steel by gradually compacting and withdrawing the steel casing. So this black are the your steel casing. So the steel casing is provided, then this shell, corrugated steel shell is there. You provide the concrete and then you remove the casing and the concrete is filled inside the hole. BSP base driven piles. This pile consists of helically welded shell of steel plate. A concrete plug is provided at the bottom of the shell. Driving is done by allowing hammer to fall on the concrete plug. The casing is driven to the desired depth and then it is filled with concrete. So this is your ground level and this is your pile. Pile hammer is provided at the top. And there is a concrete plug here filled with concrete, and with the help of the hammer you insert the base driven piles. Swage piles, it is used with advantage of driving in very hard, or it is designed to leave watertight shell for some time filling of the concrete. Steel shell is placed on the precast concrete plug. Pipe is driven over plug under the core, reach the plug, then pipe is swaged out by taper of plug which form watertight joint. Core is removed and pipe is filled with concrete. So you can see the from the first step here, this is your concrete swage, and you are filling the concrete, inserting it inside. These are your shell and these are your cores. While inserting and pressing it inside, the concrete material is filled here inside. Precast concrete plug is inserted inside up to the hard strata here. And when it is done, then the shell is removed. Core is removed and the concrete is filled inside the shell of the which these pipes, which are watertight. Button bottom piles. It is used where increase of end bearing area is required. Pile use concrete plug shape of button, which enlarge hole in soil during driving. It used for length up to 23 meter. And load up to 50 tons, 12 mm thick steel pipe set on concrete button which have diameter of 25 mm. Pipe and button driven to specified depth. The casing is removed and concrete is placed with reinforcement. So from here, if you can see, there is a button like concrete plug. There is a steel casing. Then you have to insert it inside up to the hard strata here. When you are having the start hard strata reached, then the shell is removed and casing is removed, and then the concrete is filled inside the hole. Uncased, they are simplex, Frankie, vibro, pedestal, and pressure type. These are uncased. Simplex piles. Simplex piles can be driven through soft or hard soil, steel tube fitted with a cast iron shoe. You can see the first figure. So first figure, which is a steel cast iron shoe at the bottom. Here, this is a cast iron shoe at the bottom, is driven into the ground up to a desired depth with required depth. When you reach the required depth, if the reinforcement is necessary, it put in the tube, then concrete is poured in the pile. Tube is driven slowly without concrete being tamped. That means when you reach the required depth, you just pour the concrete inside without tamping it, and you remove this casing and the concrete is filled up to the required depth. Frankie piles. It is used at place where high load is transferred, example marine structures. Plug of dry concrete is formed on ground by heavy removal pipe shell. So you can see this is a pipe shell and this is the marine structure where you are required this, and the dry concrete is poured inside this. Plug of dry concrete is formed on ground by heavy removable shell pile. So this is a pile, and from here you are inserting the concrete by help of diesel operating hammer of 20 to 30 kilonewtons. So this blue color is your diesel hammer. Is driven at desired depth. Diameter of the pile is 50 to 60 centimeter, while an enlargement is about 20 centimeter. That means this is 50 to 60, and when you enlarge it, it becomes near about 90 centimeter. Capacity of the pile is 60 tons to 90 tons of the load it can carry. Vibro piles. The type of pile is best suited for places where ground is soft and offers little frictional resistance to the flow of concrete. Piles are formed by driving a steel tube and shoe filling with concrete and withdraw steel tube. So if you can see, this is the steel tube and this is the shoe here. So you have to drive this up to a required depth. And since there is no hard strata, it is used for frictional resistance. Piles are formed by driving a steel tube and shoe, filling with concrete and withdraw steel tube. So this is the concrete which is filled and this black color is your steel tube, then it is withdrawn. Diameter of the pile 35 to 50 centimeter for load of 60 to 70 tons. Length of pile is 25 meter. So length of pile is 25 meter and above. Steel tube is fitted with cast iron shoe by 2 to 2.5 ton hammer by 40 blow per minute with stroke about 1.4 meter. So this is the steel casing which is inserted inside, which is near about 2.25 ton for number of blows of 40 per minute. When the shoe and tube reach the desired level, tube is filled with concrete and the tube is withdrawn at 80 blow per minute by the hammer. Steel tube is withdrawn, leaving the shoe in place, and the pile is formed with corrugation up along its height. So this is the shoe which is left, this is the concrete which is filled, and this is the casing. Next is your pedestal piles. It is used where thin bearing stratum is reached with reasonable depth. Pedestal pile gives the effect of spread footing on the thin bearing stratum. Core and casing are driven together into the ground till reach the desired level. Core is taken out and a charge of concrete is placed in the tube. The core is given placed, again placed in the casing to rest on the top of poured concrete. Pressure is applied on the concrete through the core and at the same time the casing is withdrawn. So you can see here from the figure X core and Y casing. So first is your casing is taken inside, then the core is removed and concrete is filled, then core is again correlated and placed up to the top of the concrete. Pressure is applied, there is the bulb is formed. So this is known as the pressure pedestal type of pipe. Pressure pile, these piles are especially suitable for congested site where heavy vibration and noise are not permissible. Boring is done up to the required depth to tube. After withdrawn boring tool, reinforcement is placed if required. A layer of concrete is laid and pressure cap is provided at the top of tube. Composed air is admitted through pipe by means of compressed air. Care should be taken that some portion of concrete remain at bottom when tube is lifted for receiving new layer. So you can see from here you are inserting the pipes, then you are inserting the concrete with the help of the hammer. When the required depth is placed, you are again just hammering, filling up the concrete, hammering, and the total ground level is reached with respect to your casing and your concrete filling. Steel piles. Commonly used steel piles are H piles, box piles, and tube piles. So H piles, these piles are usually of wide flange section. They are suitable for trestle type structure in which pile extend above ground level and act as column. They have small cross section area, therefore they can be easily driven in soil. It is used as a long pile with high bearing capacity. So this is the assembly how you are driving inside the H type. It is having a H shape, so that is known as your H type piles. Box piles, so these are your shape of the box piles and how they are placed inside the soil. These are your tube piles. So box pile are rectangular or octagonal in form filled with concrete. These piles are used when not possible to drive H piles into hard strata. Tube piles or pipe steel are driven into the ground. Concrete is filled inside the tube piles. Because of circular cross section, tube piles are easy to handle and easy to drive in. Timber pile. These are the timber piles. These are the composite piles. These piles are prepared from trunks of trees. They may be circular or square. Diameter of the pile are 30 to 50 centimeter and length not exceeding 20 times its top width. At bottom, a cast iron shoe is provided and at the top of a steel plate is fixed. For group pile, each pile is brought at the same level and concrete plate is provided to have common platform. This is the covering which is given to this timber piles. And the concrete is provided at the platform bottom so that it is not removed easily. Composite pile, this is the type of construction in which piles of two different materials are driven one over the other. They act together to perform the function of a single pile. In this pile, advantage is taken of durability of concrete piles and cheapest of the timber pile. Timber pile is terminated just at the level of the groundwater table. Okay. Timber piles. These piles are prepared from the trunks which we have already done. Composite piles. This is the type of construction in which piles of two different are used. So if you can see, this is the concrete, this is the timber at the bottom level of the ground level. And after a ground level, this timber pile is provided, and at the top of this timber pile, concrete pile is provided to support the structure, and this will act as a one member. Classification based on method of installation. Driven pile, driven and cast in situ piles, screw piles, jack pile. So driven pile, these piles are driven into the ground by applying blow with a heavy hammer. Timber, steel and precast concrete pile are installed by driving. So this is your hydraulic machine, this is your hammer, this is your pile. You are giving number of blows, and by number of blows, this is how you are inserting the pile inside the soil. Driven and cast in situ pile. These piles are formed by driving a casing with a closed bottom end into the soil. The casing is later filled with concrete. The casing may or may not be withdrawn. So this is the casing. This casing, with the help of hammer, is inserted inside the soft soil. Then the cage of steel is inserted, and then it is filled with concrete. And then the casing is removed. Bore and cast in situ piles. These piles are formed by excavating a hole into the ground and then filling with the concrete. So, hole is inserted inside the ground and it is filled with concrete. So, these are the huge machineries which are used for the excavating the hole inside the ground. Positioning rig of pile shot. This is the